Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome to Repair and Replace. If your oven isn't heating properly, then it's likely that one of the heating elements is not working. In this episode, first we'll learn how it all works. Then we'll test the heating element. And finally, we'll see how to install a new one. Now, if your oven isn't heating on any mode, then it's most likely a faulty temperature sensor or an issue with the power. You can see how to troubleshoot this in the video linked below. Electric ovens are pretty simple at a base level. When electricity passes through the heating element, the resistance in the material generates heat. After preheating, the control board monitors the temperature sensor. It will cycle the elements on and off to maintain the cooking temperature. Most ovens have a bake element on the bottom and a broil element on the top. The broil setting uses only the broil element to brown the top of the food. The bake setting uses a combination of both elements to heat the entire oven. Roughly 80% of the heat coming from the bake element and about 20% coming from the broil. When a heating element fails, it might appear burnt or blistered, but the failure is not always visible. From the back of the oven, we can check the elements for continuity. A continuity test will determine if there's a continuous path for electricity to flow through. Without continuity, there is no resistance, and the element will not heat up. To begin, you might need a screwdriver, a nut driver, gloves, and a multimeter. Always be safe and disconnect the power at the breaker. Since there might be some sharp edges, it's best to wear cut-resistant gloves. Gently pull the range slightly away from the wall. As soon as there's enough room, go in behind and unplug it from the receptacle. Make sure that there isn't too much tension on the cord. Now, slide the range all the way out so you have plenty of room to work. On the back of the oven is a cover panel. Some models have a small panel near the top and a larger panel near the bottom. Now remove the screws. The panel will likely be sitting on several hooks. Simply lift up to remove the panel. First, locate the element on the back of the oven and disconnect the wires. Set your multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. Now touch each probe to each terminal. If you have continuity and a resistance reading between 10 to 40 ohms, then the element is good. If there is no continuity or the resistance is far outside of that range, then the element is faulty and will need to be replaced. Another possibility is that the element has shorted through the frame of the oven. Set your multimeter to 1,000 ohms or higher and test from one of the element terminals to the bare metal of the oven's body. Note, this will not work on a painted surface. If you get any continuity reading, then the element is shorting and will also need to be replaced. When choosing a replacement, make sure that the new element has the same wattage, shape, and configuration. To find a match, enter your model number on the AMRE Supply website. This will bring up a parts breakdown with the exact replacement parts listed on the side. In many cases, it can be helpful to remove the oven door. Many doors have locking tabs that secure the door hinges. Use a flat blade screwdriver to release the locks. Next, lift up to move the door off the hinges. First, disconnect the wires, if you haven't already. Now, remove the oven racks. The inside of the oven can be greasy, so it's best to give it a quick wipe. If you're replacing the broil element, then you'll have to remove the two mounting screws at the front, as well as the two mounting screws at the back. Slide the element forward and remove it. Fake elements on the bottom are removed in a similar way, but only have two mounting screws at the back. Now, if you have a convection oven, then you'll most likely have a hidden bake element installed under a smooth metal plate. First, remove the screws and lift up the plate. In some models, the plate will slide out from the back of the oven. Now unscrew and remove the element. Align the new heating element. Next, tighten the screws. For hidden bake elements, slide the bottom plate in and tighten the screws. Now, replace the oven racks. Finally, reconnect the wires. Align the door hinges into the slots on the oven. Next, open the door all the way. Now, push the locking tabs back into place and close the door. Align the back panel and replace the screws. Now, plug in the cord and push the range back into place. Next, reconnect the power. Before cooking any food, it's recommended to turn on your oven and let it heat up for 10 minutes. You may notice a small amount of smoke the first time it heats up. This is normal, as it's just the protective coating burning off the new element. Finally, let the oven cool down and air out. Now, if the element still doesn't turn on after it's been replaced, then it's likely a faulty wire or an issue with the control board. You can learn more in the video linked below. For more troubleshooting videos on water heaters, furnaces, and appliances, then subscribe to our channel. And if you need help, you can call or visit our AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.